Hello students, let's continue with the poem Nose versus Eyes by William Cowper. Today we'll be discussing brainstorming questions of the poem, but before that let's see the figures of speech in the poem. Now see here the very first line of the poem, between nose and eyes a strange contest arose. Here in this line you will find figure of speech inversion. Why? Because this line is not in correct prose order. Here the correct prose order should be a strange contest arose between nose and eyes. So when the line is not in correct prose order, then you will write there figure of speech inversion. Keep in mind this line has inversion. Now after that the fourth line here, to which the said spectacles ought to belong. Here the sound of letter S is repeated, so here you can say the figure of speech alliteration comes. After that the second stanza, see here, so tongue was the lawyer and argued the cause with great deal of skill and a wig full of learning. Now here wig, now what does wig represent here? Wig represents actually a head full of learning. Means here see it is mentioned, wig is a special covering of the head made of artificial hair which is worn by the judges. So here wig represents the judge here. So here the word is, the actually the word wig represents a head full of learning, means the person who is very good at judgment, the person who shows good judgment, who can, he is a very learned person here. So here you can say figure of speech will be metonymy. Metonymy is a new figure of speech today which I am introducing to you all. So I'll show you some more examples of the same, so you can understand it more nicely. See here, metonymy is a type of figurative language, means figures of speech in which an object or concept is referred to not by its own name. Here they are not giving the name of the judge, they are not telling the head wig full of learning means the person full of learning, or you can say the judge here. They are not referring to the name of the person here. So which an object or concept is referred to not by its own name, but instead by the name of something closely associated with. Now here they are saying here the wig is worn by the judges only. The special covering of the head means the artificial hair covering of the head is worn by judges only in the court. So here the wig represents whom? The judges. So instead of telling the judges or the head full of learning, they have used the word wig. So here the figure of speech will be metonymy. So here you have to keep in mind metonymy is a figure of speech in which an object or concept is referred to not by its own name, but instead by the name of something closely associated with. Now see here, boots on the ground. Now boots on the ground means what? Here it means soldiers. So here you can say it is a phrase which is generally refers to the deployed members of the military, means whom? The soldier. Instead of telling soldiers, what they are saying? Boots on the ground. Then head count means instead of telling count the number of people, they are telling head count. Then lend a ear. See here, instead of telling to listen here, lend a hand, instead of telling to help someone, what they are telling here? To lend her hand. So here instead of telling help, to help someone, they are saying lend a hand. So here it means the figure of speech metonymy here is here. The next one, from the cradle to the grave. Now this expression also tells you about the whole person's life, from the time he is born till he dies here. So instead of telling here the life of the person, they are saying here from cradle to the grave. So here you have to keep in mind figure of speech in which an object or concept is referred to not by its own name. They are not saying life of the person or to help or number of people or soldier, but instead by the name of something closely associated with. Who wears boots on the ground and marches? Soldiers. Yes or no? And how we count the number of people? From their heads only. how many heads you can see, you count accordingly. And how we help someone through by our hand, then how we can you can say come to know about the life of the person from the time he is born from the till the time he dies here. So here accordingly you have to keep in mind when we speak about an object or concept, refer to by not its name but by something which is closely associated to him or her, or then you can say it is metonymy. I hope you have understood it nicely. After that, the next figures of speech here, see here in the same stanza, while Chief Baron here sat to balance the laws. Now here the figure of speech here you can say is a metaphor. Why it is metaphor here? Because here indirect comparison is made between here and the Chief Baron, means the judge. Here, who is the judge in the poem? Here is the judge in the poem. So here you can say there is indirect comparison made between Chief Baron and here. So here it is metaphor. See these two lines. While Chief Baron here sat to balance the laws, so famed for his talent in nicely discerning. Means who is famed for his talent to give good decision? Judges. So here is compared with judges, indirectly compared with judges. So here you can say figure of speech metaphor will come in these two lines. And here children, throughout the poem you will find figure of speech personification. Why? Because the sensory organs like nose, ears, eye, they all are given you can see human quality here. All are given human quality in the poem. So here the figure of speech personification also you can find in throughout the poem here. After that, see here, fourth paragraph, see here. As wide as the ridge of the nose is, in short, designed to sit close to it just like a saddle. Here also direct comparison is made here. See here. As wide as the ridge of the nose is, in short, designed to sit close to it just like a saddle. How? They are saying on the saddle, the person becomes very comfortable while he is riding a horse or a camel. In the same way, they are saying the spectacles are made or prepared in such a way so that it fits on the ridge of the person here, person's nose here. So that's why here you can say direct comparison is made between the nose of the person, the ridge of the nose of the person to the saddle here. So figure of speech simile will be you can say is used here. After that, see here. You can say interrogation is there in this line. Pray who would or who could wear the spectacle? Question mark is there. So here question is asked for emphasis. You can say figure of speech enter interrogation. After that, see here these lines. See here. But what were his arguments? Few people know. So here you can say few people know what were his arguments. So here also inversion, because lines are not in correct prose order. For the court did not think they were equally wise. You can say the court did not think they were equally wise. Then, okay, I think I have told you whatever the figures of speeches are there, but still you can go through the entire poem and see if you can find some more here. Now we'll start with the brainstorming questions of the poem. See here, state whether the following statements are true or false. Now, correct the false statement. Now here children, you can say the nose can use spectacles. According to you, what is correct? Can the nose use spectacles? So you can say false. The nose cannot use spectacles here. The spectacle uses the nose here. It is the spectacles are of no use to nose. Nose cannot do anything for of spectacle here. When the person's eyesight is weak, so when he puts on his spectacle, he can see it more clearly. So it is helpful for the eyesight. It is not helpful for the spectacle here. And so here you can say the statement is wrong. nose cannot use the spectacle, but you can say the spectacle uses the nose to fit on the face of the person here. Then eyes have to be shut when the nose wears or put on the spectacles. So here you can say, according to the poem, this is true because this was the verdict given by the judge, that is here. So this statement is true according to the poem, you have to mention here. After that, the ear was appointed as a judge. So correct, the ear was appointed as a judge, we all know it. Eyes cannot use spectacles. So yes, here according to the poem, this is also very true here, because the judge has given the verdict that the spectacles belong to nose and eyes have to be shut whenever it is put on the nose here. So here according to the poem, this statement is true. After that, see here, discuss with your partner and match the following expression given in the column A with their interpretations in column B. See here, while the chief baron here sat to balance the laws. Now what you can say here? He was chief baron means judge. So here you can say the responsibility of giving verdict rested on the shoulders of hearing organ means the ear. Then they are made with the straddle as wide as the ridge of the nose is. So here you can say spectacles are meant for none other than but nose. Means the lawyer. You can say the tongue is proving its point by saying that the spectacles are made according to the ridge of the nose here. So it belongs to the nose only. Then that whenever the nose put his spectacles on by daylight or candlelight, eyes should be shut. So here you can say this line is correct. Eyes are refrained from using spectacles. They are not allowed to use spectacles. See here. By daylight and candlelight, eyes should be shut. So here you can say this is the correct answer for it. So his lordship decreed with a grave, solemn tone, decisive and clear, without one if or but. Means here, the judge delivered the firm verdict, means the judgment here, final decision, without any doubt. After that, see here, the tongue justifies the positions of the spectacles on behalf of the nose. Pick up the expressions from the poem that argue in favor of the nose and complete the following Venn diagram. See here, arguments in favor of the nose. What does the tongue try to prove in favor of the nose? It tries to tell that the nose had been wearing spectacles from time immemorial. Yes or no? In the poem it has been said that the nose had been wearing spectacles from time immemorial. Then the spectacles are designed to fit perfectly on the ridge of the nose. Then it is impossible for a face without nose to wear the spectacle. So these were the points in the argument. After that, comment on the following characters depicted in the poem in a sentence or a phrase. On the nose, what does it say? Nose strongly puts his point to be the owner of the spectacle. He could present his case to the lawyer very convincingly so that the lawyer could confidently fight his case. On the other hand, eyes could not convince the lawyer to present his case and make him the winner. Eyes accepted whatever the verdict was given by the judge. After that, lend thy ears to all but few thy tongue is a famous quote by William Shakespeare justified. Now you have to explain this particular quote given by William Shakespeare. It is a very, you can say, meaningful quote here. William Shakespeare, he wants to tell us that whenever we are listening to someone or whenever we are lending our ear to someone here, for that time we have to listen to him or her very carefully. Here we should not get distracted, or we should not disturb the person. We should not feel the person feel that we are not interested in his or her talk. We should listen to them very carefully. But few thy tongue. But in case suppose there is any disagreement or if you are giving any opinion, at that time you should speak very less. You never know, Chiranya, that whatever you are speaking, you might hurt the feelings of other, or you might say something wrong and then you will have to regret and all. So for that reason, the writer wants to tell you here that when you are listening, you should listen with very carefully with complete attention towards the person. But when you are speaking, you have to speak very less. After that, pick out the examples of inversion from the poem here. Now, I have given you many examples of inversion, that when the lines are not in correct prose order, you can go through again and write those examples here. After that, justify the verdict delivered in the poem here. Now, how you can justify it? Whatever has been told in the poem, according to you, is it correct? So here you can say whatever the points are being proven by the tongue here, whatever the points are given by the tongue, that the spectacles are prepared according to the size of the ridge of the nose, and if the person is not having nose on his face, he cannot wear the spectacle, and the nose had been wearing the spectacle from time immemorial. All these statements are very true here, you can say. So here you can say the arguments which the tongue has given are absolutely correct one, and a person without face cannot a person without nose on his face cannot wear the spectacles at all, even though if it is required by the weak eyesight of the person. So that you can say it is very correct. After that, compose two lines of your own on any sensory organ. Here, this one you have to do here, children. After that, imagine that you are a lawyer defending the case of the eyes in the court. Present your counter statement in support of your client. Now, how you will try to prove the point of the eyes here? You can say, though whatever the nose is saying, that it had been wearing the spectacle from time immemorial, or you can say the size of the spectacle is according to the ridge of the nose, or you can say if the person is not having nose on the face, he cannot wear the spectacle. Still, here you can say the spectacles are mainly meant for the eyes only. If the person's eyesight is weak, for that reason he requires the you can say spectacles here, the lenses here. If there is no problem in the eyesight, then there is no point of wearing the spectacle here. So here you can say the main aim or the main objective for a person to wear a spectacle is for the purpose of eye only. Though it has been supported, though we agree that it is only with the help of the nose only the person can wear the eye. And the thing is also very correct, because naturally, the God has made us, the nose is right below the eyes. So when we wear the spectacle here, the support is given to wear the spectacle properly by the nose. But we cannot deny the fact that it is mainly meant for eyesight only. The person who are having weak eyesight. So here you can say, according to me, yourself, or according to me, the main owner of the spectacle is eye only, not the nose. After that, children, you have to write this appreciation of the poem. I have explained to you all how to write appreciation of the poem, that you have to write the about the poem, poet and title. Then you have to write the theme of the poem, that it is a satirical poem wherein the poet tries to stress up the point where the poor person are deprived of justice because they could not prove themselves very nicely, because here the poet has really mocked at the blind justice, where it only believes in the evidences. It does not think about the actual fact here. And then you have to write the figures of speech in the poem. You have to write the tone of the poem, what is the message of the poem, And what is your view about the poem, whether you like it or not like it, that you have to write. Then after that, the summary of the poem, you have to write the gist of the poem here, children. I've explained to you all how to write the summary also. You have to write about the poem, poet and title, and in short, you have to write what is the poem about, not going into details. I hope you have understood this. Children, while explaining to you all, I forgot to tell you all about one more figure of speech here, that is oxymoron. See here, by daylight or candlelight, eyes should be shut. Here, two opposite words are placed side by side to enhance the effect of the poem here. Daylight and candlelight, two opposite words are used. So here the figure of speech, you can say oxymoron is used. Keep my listen to carefully what I'm saying. The figure of speech oxymoron is used in this line. Here it means the two opposite words are placed side by side to enhance the effect of the poem here. I hope you have understood the poem and question answers very nicely. Go through the video lecture again and try to write this answer in your notebook so that you become thorough with the poem. Please see to it that you practice writing appreciation and summary, because these two questions are for sure that is there in your paper pattern. You will get for in your exam to write the summary of the poem, to write the appreciation of the poem. So for all the poems which we have done till now, you need to learn to write appreciation and summary so that you are thorough with those questions. Thank you.